Hi, I'm Graham, and I'm here to show you today how to plant a heart-shaped planter. Let's get into it. Here are a couple of the basic things you'll need to plant your planter. I like to use a Terra Cotta planter to stick this planter in to hold it steady so that way you can move it around and play with it and see the angle you want and pack the dirt nice and compact. The soil I like to use is this palm, citrus, and cactus soil. And lastly, you're gonna need some succulents. Particularly succulents because they require little water, and the more water you add to this planter, the more it will slowly disintegrate over time. So I like to use succulents that require less water. Some more little guys we're gonna add to this. I'm gonna try to get as many of these plants in here as possible. I think succulents like to live together, like a little family in their heart. I always like to start with the largest succulent I have and then go from there. This particular one looks just a little too deep for my planter, so I'm gonna take it out by squeezing the base and slowly and gently letting the top come out. So it's a little too long. I'm gonna take about an inch or two off of the bottom. So just rip off those roots. And then I'm going to squeeze my plant flat a little bit, just to give it more room to stick into this planter. I'm gonna go just a little bit off of the center when I place it here. Then I'm gonna add a little bit of this palm and cactus soil to both sides to fill in the bottom. Don't be afraid to make a mess because you're going to. So do this outside probably. Now I'm gonna give this other guy, same thing. I'm gonna squeeze his little container gently to break up the roots. And I just got these plants from a box store. Let's see, I'm gonna shove him into here. Be gentle with your plants. They don't like to be handled aggressively. Take that guy, add a little bit more soil. Now I'm pushing the soil all the way to the bottom to make sure there's no air gaps. I want these plants to be pretty settled in where they're at. I don't want them to move around. Make sure to compact it. Next, I'll add one of these square guys. The square guys are the same where you push around the base of the plastic to release the roots, and that helps when you gently need to pull up on them to get them out. I'll place this guy in right back here. I think I can probably get two in there. I'm gonna put one on this side. I think I'm just gonna add one more succulent right in here, and it'll be this guy. Having this terracotta planter makes it so much easier than trying to put soil into this plant when it's on the ground. Oh boy, that's very hard in comparison. Nice and flat level. So now that I got all my plants into my planter, I'm gonna just go in very ornately or very methodically and fill in every possible little hole that I think water might find its way to and seep down into the cracks. So I'm just filling the whole area up with dirt. Tucking in on the dirt, giving it a good night's rest. There's your little blanket of dirt. It's just like you look. It doesn't hurt to name your succulents. This fuzzy one looks like an Alfred. Okay, I think I'm gonna go ahead and find some rocks to add into this just to give it a different look, make it pop a little bit better. Okay, I went out front and I was able to find some cool little white rocks. These will definitely help with the color contrast. So the light and dark greens will really pop against the natural aging of the reclaimed wood. Nice light colors versus the dark, deep blue. Same thing, being very methodical and placing these rocks with a purpose. Well, I hope this video was helpful and informative to help you get your planters looking cute and ready for your gift to give to whoever you're going to give it to, or for yourself to enjoy looking through the windows. Enjoy your hearts. See you later. Be sure to follow along and watch what else we make.